So let us summarize this into the following lemma. The G from E to E be any bijective isometry on a normed linear space E. For AB in E with G of A equal to A and G of B equal to B, we have G of Z is equal to Z, where Z is equal to A plus B divided by 2. Namely, if G fixes the endpoints of a line segment, it will fix the middle point. The proof of this lemma is a little bit tricky. The key idea in the proof of this lemma is as follows. We are going to consider the collection of all bijective isometry that fixes A and B. And we will show that any map in that collection will fix the middle point by looking at the distances from Z to G of Z for any map in that collection. We will show that distance will be equal to zero. So let me write this down carefully. Let script F sub A comma B is a collection of all bijective isometry that fixes A and B. And we consider the number lambda defined to be the supremum of all the distances from G of Z to Z, where G is in this script F sub AB. This number, by our definition, can be anything from 0 to infinity. And we will show that lambda is equal to 0. But before we do this, let us first see why lambda cannot be infinity. Lambda is finite because the norm of G of Z minus Z, if we break this down, it will be G of Z minus G of A plus A minus Z. We assume at the beginning that G of A is equal to A. So this term is, so this part is really zero. So it doesn't hurt to add this part. And by the triangle inequality, this is less than or equal to G of Z minus G of A plus the norm of A minus Z, which by the fact that G is an isometry, so this guy will be equal to twice of the norm of Z minus A. And this is a finite number because we fixed A and Z. Here Z is just A plus B minus, here Z is just A plus B divided by 2. And in particular, the finiteness of this will be independent of the choice of Z. So, lambda is a finite number. Now here comes the key trick. It's time to see the acrobat. We'll prove that 2 lambda is equal to lambda. So that, because lambda is a finite number, 2 lambda equal to lambda will force lambda to be equal to 0. Indeed, the psi of x to be 2z minus x, the reflection as above. Then, if you look at twice of any distance in here, we want to prove that 2 lambda is equal to lambda, so we want to look at the twice of any distance in here. This guy, if we put 2 inside, and if we break this down, we further get 2z minus g of z minus g of z. And this part, by using our idea of reflections, will be equal to psi of g of z. So, we'll transform this into the distance from g of z to its reflection. Now, because g is a bijective isometry, if we compose this guy with g inverse, we'll end up getting g inverse composed of psi composed with g applied to z minus z. So this is because g is a bijective isometry. Okay, now let us look at this map. The conjugation of psi by g. This map applied to A will be g inverse composed with psi of A, because by assumption that g is in f sub a comma b, g of A is equal to A. So this is because g is in f sub a comma b. And psi of A is equal to B from our definition, as psi is a reflection about the middle point of the line segment from A to B. But G inverse of B is again equal to B because G fixes A and B. And symmetrically, G inverse composes psi composed with G applied to B is equal to A. So, this conjugation of psi swaps A and B. And we will play the old trick that we will compose this composition of 3 maps further by psi. This new map will send A to A and B to B. And now, because psi is an isometry, since psi is a reflection, the last term in here will be equal to So we can compose both terms by psi. And now, because psi is a reflection about z, where z is a plus b divided by 2, so this guy will be equal to this composition of 4 maps applied to z minus just z. Because psi of z will be just be z. Z is the only fixed point of psi. Okay, if you look at this composition, this composition is again in f sub a comma b, because we just showed that it fixes a and b, and it is a bijective isometry, since each of the maps here is a bijective isometry. This tells us by the definition of lambda that this whole thing is less than or equal to lambda. Remember, lambda is the supremum of all the distances from z to g of z, where g is in f sub a comma b. So what we just proved is that twice of the norm of g of z minus z is less than or equal to lambda. But this g is arbitrarily chosen from f sub a comma b. So I should add here for any g in f sub a comma b. We have twice of this is less than or equal to lambda. What does this tell us? This tells us, by the definition of lambda again, as the supremum of all such things, that twice of lambda is less than or equal to lambda. But lambda is a non-negative number, so the only possible choice we will get is that lambda must be equal to zero. So the norm of g of z minus z is equal to zero for any g in f sub a comma b. So g of z is equal to z. And this finishes the proof of the lemma. And mind you, this is also our end of the proof of the Mazur-Ulam theorem. If you forget about our discussion above, let me remind you. Since the composition of 4 maps psi f inverse psi prime f is in f comma b. Remember, all those 4 maps are isometries. And this composition also fixes a and b. So it is in subgroup f a comma b. We have, by the lemma, that this composition also fixes z, the middle point of the line segment from a to b. So f inverse composed with psi prime composed with f applied to z is equal to psi inverse of z, which is just z. And so psi prime composed with f applied to z is equal to f of z by moving this guy to the right hand side. So by our definition of psi prime. Remember, psi prime is a reflection of the vector f about the point f of z. So, both f of z and z prime are fixed points of psi prime. Z prime is a fixed point of psi prime is simply from the definition, and this is what we got with the great effort above. So they are both fixed points of the same reflection, but we know from the previous property that a reflection can only have one fixed point. So f of z will be equal to z prime. And by definition, this guy is f of a plus b divided by 2, and this guy is f of a plus f of b divided by 2. And this is precisely what we want to prove. So f is affine by our proposition number 3. So we are done.